Fuck it. Fuck it. I'm here. Fuck it, I'm here. I'm here already. I'm first. I'm the first here. Hello, everybody. Hello, folks. Hold on, let me just... Hello, everybody. Sorry about that. I'll explain everything. Let me just tweet this. Hold on. It's Saturday night and I'm live on Twitch. How are yous this evening? You alright? Everything alright? I look happy. Oh, okay. Don't be daft. Daft? Any plant? What's going on? Jay Bully. Thanks for the sub. Can you say hi to my dog Yoko? Yoko, you split up the Beatles. Well done. They were shite. Hell, you fucking go. Yoko knew that it was the end of the road for the Beatles. Yoko knew. Eagle Grenade and Perish Attero and Jehen Tindall. Thanks for the subs. Your inner monologue is no Scottish good. A few people have actually said that. Dan and Cowlin, thanks for the sub. Blam Blam. Blam Blam. A Wild Ross, thanks for the bits. Any chance of a Saturday wavy hand? Blam Blam's been taken, mate, sorry. G Billy. Weekaz Galloway, thanks for the sub. Glad you liked the programme last night, Bruni. And Asa J, thanks for the bits. What night is it? This is your Saturday night. Asa J, thanks for the 200 bits. You look beautiful for the age of 50. Thank you very much, mate. 46 this month, everybody. 46 in 17 days. Cup of bean juice, thanks for the 213. So can I get a silly noise to help me go to sleep? Swanton, thanks for the 7-month resub. Happy TV retirement. Let me hope that impending medical ailments aren't too severe. Nah, it'll be fine. By the way, can I just say, if any of yous are thinking, what's this all about, the Lemmy getting up the telly stuff? Is he dying? No, I'm living. No, I'm not dying. In case you think I am, but that's just my way of looking at it. No, I'm. There's nothing wrong with me, fine. I mean, nobody said anything. Nobody cares. Wee man Geordie, thanks for the sub. Thank you very much. Al and Bing 909, thanks for the subs. Hopefully won't be home soon. JG, thanks for the sub. And Radar Diverse, thanks for the subs. Radar died for this. 6 months with the love of my life. Tell Lynn you'll be me. Cheers. No, I think I've had enough of that for one stream. Thank you very much. I think I've had enough of that. That carry on. Moody Bin, thanks to the three habits. I can't think of anything funny to put here. That's fine. Still can't believe it. To those of you who know what I'm talking about, lifer, funny old world, isn't it? Funny old world. Well, each to their own. Each to their own. Kid, hello, your cat Bindle, Manic Garth. Night shift's looking better now. Ladies and gents, let's get some fucking trucking on the go. Yous are saying Among Us, I'm not in the mood for Among Us, I'm in the mood for some trucking, right? I've come on here to chat to yous, not to chat to anybody else, to chat to yous. I want to talk to yous. Alright? That's what I'm on for. I'm here to talk to yous. Alright? Billy, fucking name mates. I do have mates. I've got thousands of mates. Yous. Yous are better than physical in the flesh mates, because I can switch yous off anytime I get bored of yous. That's why, you know, if there's any talk about like meeting up when coronavirus is finished, which is hopefully never going to happen. I mean, in terms of that, just for a wee joke. Why I'm like, I don't think I will meet up. And then I say that a day, and then I think about it, I go, fuck that, man. Because I was thinking about this the other day. Right? Henke and Kid, Bintac, B Webster, Underspaces, thanks for subs, thank you very much. Jilty Jenks, thanks for subs, thank you very much. You're looking beautiful tonight, young man, thank you very much. I was thinking, let's say, once this is all here and done, and you can meet up with a big group of people, imagine there was a big meet up, like there was before. Would I meet up? I thought about it again just like yesterday or the day before, and I thought, instant feeling is no. Don't want to meet anybody. I have no negative emotions about this way of communicating with people. I have negative emotions about communicating, meeting up with people in the flesh. Negative things happen when I meet up with people in the flesh. It's fairly problem free in this medium, right? The problem with me is this. See, when I this is you've got to know yourself. I'm really interested in me and my thoughts. I don't get a lot of pleasure for other things, other people, and other things. I just don't. I just don't. Me and Lynn were watching Jane McDonald Weekend Things the night, right? And I was looking at different places. She really liked to look at them. And I was thinking, fuck me, it almost stresses me out looking at these places. Sidgies, which I've already been to, and some other places. And it almost stresses me out because I don't have that instant feeling, oh God, that's beautiful, that's amazing. And it almost feels like Hogmanay or Christmas, if you're the sort of person who isn't up for it, but everybody's like, oh, this is fucking brilliant. Are you looking forward to it? You must be real. So it stresses me out that I feel different. And I go, what is it that stresses me out about it? I don't know. I'm just prone to fucking boredom. I'm prone to boredom so fucking much without drinking. And I'm just scared of no looking fucking happy all the time. Everything's better with a wee fucking drink, and you have a wee wine, a wee shandy. Everything feels fucking good. Everything feels better if you're like me. Everything feels better with a wee drink. Without drinking, a lot of I'm kind of like, I'm not completely like that. I'm not like, you know, the foot tapping away and I'm like, I'm just like, I'm not interested in buildings, I'm not interested in nice weather, I'm not interested in beaches, I'm not interested in any of these things. I need something to be happening, or I need to be doing something. I need to be doing something. Like that. So it kind of stresses me because I don't feel like other fucking people. I don't feel like other fucking people. Euro Truck Simulator 2. So it would chill me out to be able to go to these places as long as I cannot like it. That would make me like it. Do you know what I mean? Lord Butler, thanks for the sub. It was inspiring to hear that despite your anxiety, you went on to make some of the best TV content of the generation. You fucking did it, man. I've one request. Enjoy your retirement. Thank you very much, mate. Butts, Carlton, Yojo, G, and Chalet Rouge, thanks for the subs. We could really do for a word for it. It's not actually a year in a suggestion. Instead of anniversary, monthiversary. Let me just put the game on the screen. That was a cracker. That. I suppose that's why I gave up the telly thing. Also because I meant to say hing here and also thing, and it came out as the telly thing. The telly thing. Instead of saying the telly thing or the telly thing, I bottled the jump. You know, you get people in videos, they run to take a jump at something, they bottle it at the last minute, so they end up falling air into whatever the fucking gap is. Instead of like stopping or jumping, they go, ah, fuck. So instead of saying, what was I saying? Something the thing or something the hang, but what was I actually talking about? The telly hang or the telly thing, I sort of fucked it up, so I ended up saying two. The telly thing. Like instead of saying like somebody serving you, and instead of saying cheers, like I've thought about saying cheers, and I've thought about saying ta, and up saying cha. I did it with a fucking neighbour the other day, actually. I said something like, it was like, instead of morning and alright, what did I say? Instead of like hi and alright, it's like hi, hi, hi. I don't know what it was, but it was like, It was weird. I fucked it up. It makes you look like you're actually nervous to step out the fucking door. And you want to make up for it by being dead bold and just go out here. Fuck your fucking lot, yous, man. I'm not saying hello to any's. Yous can all fuck off. I'm scared. I'm scared of yous. Right, wait a minute. We're still on a... Right, so everybody, we're off to Istanbul, which is the easternmost part of this entire game. And then from Istanbul, we're going to go all the fucking way to... Let's go to somewhere in France. But first, Istanbul, the Constantinople, Istanbul, Constantinople. G. Campbell thinks the tuna bits. What? Who's your favourite director? Maybe Hitchcock. Probably Hitchcock. Also, like, you know, your Stan Kubrick. Just your usual. Sorry, I haven't got any fancy answers for you. That's not my business at all. Sideways. Some right smart arses in my seventh school, like, they might be giants. Right smart arses, so they were. At least they thought they were. But where are they now? Leopard Page, thanks. Panglossius, zero bigs, bada bing. Thanks for the subs, thanks. Halliverts, 4K 5G 17 fucking months, thank you very much, mate. Let's drive, everybody. Let's fucking drive and stop right there. Let's make that fucking... Let's make my face much bigger. It's Saturday night, let's go big. Who's laughing now? Huh? Give a shout out for Mecha Weege, by the way, very funny streamer. Very funny. Miss my sub, but I've not missed anybody. I've just simply not got into it yet. Wait a minute, maybe I did miss it actually. I don't. Fud Muffin, thanks for the sub. Love that tattoo sketch. Love the totally unnecessary but completely needed fart effect. Lynn was pissing herself with that. It goes to show you. Just putting a fart sound and that's it. Smiley, Riser, Bolton. Glad you like the book. Thanks for the subs. Caminator, thanks for 200 bits here. Ignore my last comment, you're over it. Rosebury, thanks for the 17.3 subs, thanks. Timber Wagons, thanks for the bits. What happened to the Boggle? Oh! Lynn must have taken it away. We'll run out of Boggle. So there you go, that Boggle was now being fucking used. That Boggle was now being used. There you go. Better order some new Boggle then, because that was the last. Time for another 45 roll fucking batch of bog rolls. Test. Oh, it's working. Just that compressor. It's not really making that. 1, 2, 3. That's funny, it's not making the game volume any quieter. Gives me a second. Just want to test the compressor here, the thingy. Threshold -17. Right, so, well, you can maybe bring that a wee bit closer, like there, and bring that down to maybe -20. Right. Good thing. Test. Test, it dips it just a wee bit more. Um, Gavanch, thanks for the bits. Nothing wrong with being comfy and cosy. You do you, thank you very much. Shane, thanks for the sub. Konza, Bully's Prize Bowl, thanks for the subs and bits. Ironic Sparkles, Matthew, Mideku, thanks for the subs and bits. Can you say, you're getting a COVID test on Monday, can you say, you hope I die? I can't do that, no. No put my teeth or I would. I can think it if you like, but I'm not allowed to say it. Fair getting Gingleberry and Yusari in the goal, thanks for the subs. I think my girlfriend is leaving me, let's get trucking. Just get in the old truck. Stand and deliver! Here we go. You're welcome, Kate. Thank you very much for helping. Mideku, thanks for two and a bits. Thank you very much. Jester, thanks for the 213 sub. Enjoyed last night's show, Limmy. Reminded me of Dennis Norden's Laughter Files.
If you're one of those people who...
Would you make it that? Many of you youngsters will know how good an impression that was. Everybody old enough to remember, like, Mike Yardfield, impressionist. You'll know that was fucking good, that. You'll know that was good. Hello, everybody. Hello, folks. I was at the house today, meeting up with my dad. Came back, went for a nap. Daniel, my son Daniel, bet me at Mortal Kombat 11. But it's only because, and I was beat, I bet, maybe it was last night that happened. I bet him, hold on. Huge risk, it's fine. You know, I bet him about 3-4 times. I thought, I'm not fucking letting him win. He needs to learn how to fucking lose. The reason why he gets so fucking bad-tempered with games is because he's an only child and I've been letting him fucking win too much. If he had a fucking brother or sister beating him at things, he would have learned how to fucking lose. So I thought, no. It's time to get fucking absolutely fucking whipped at these games. I beat him four times, but then he actually genuinely started beating me. But the thing is, he's been practicing. Fuck! Shit. We're alright. It's alright. It's alright. It's alright. There we are. Everything's fine. There we go. Everything's in full working order. Whoops. Ring button. Ring button. I went Baraka. I went Baraka. I just know, this is all I know. How to shoot. How to do this move where I sort of whip my knives up. How to grab, how to throw, how to block. That's it. And a jump and kick. That's it. I said to him, this is Mortal Kombat 11. I said to him, Daniel, next time I play this, I will be absolutely destroying you at it because I'm going to learn combos. And I know that you don't have the patience to learn combos by day. And I'm going to tell him tomorrow, Daniel, I want to win more than you want to win, right? That's the difference between me and you. It's not true though. It's not true actually. He really does want to win. He's not willing to put the work in though. He's better at Sekiro than me. He's better at Dark Souls than me. James Hay and Big Fall, thanks for the subs. Done that again. You're alright, you're alright, you're alright, you're alright. Blam and Demoko. Zethith, the circle blocker. Thanks for the subs. Thank you very much. Street Fighter, I was going to Street Fighter 5 and I was learning a few combos. I was beating him at that. He was getting really pissed off at that. But I'm going to beat him. I'm going to beat him. To be done. I'm going to go Baraka. Baraka's who I always... Well, thanks. Sweaty Bezosack and... Jacobel. Sweaty Bezosack, Sweaty Bezosack, Jacobel, Bezosack, Sweaty Bezosack. Well done. Sweaty Bezosack, Jacobel, Sweaty Bezosack. Yeah, Kabil, thanks for £3. Meant to ask this in the Q&A, but if you had to live as one of your TV or internet characters for the rest of your life, who would you be and why? DD, because it's just a fairly chilled out lifestyle, although it's got one or two wee problems. And who's the other one, Sweaty? Sweaty... Bezosack. Right, I'm going all the way back here. Like, that's me back 21 or so. I'm going to go back to the beginning. Space Furby, thanks for the sub. Sweaty. There's Fergie, keep your eyes on Fergie. Nothing, let's keep your eyes on Riser. I love you, that's part of it. Sweaty. Nope, King J, SJ, Evan Boston, Slap. It's all right, thanks to 200 bits. Congrats on the Taylor retirement. David could get an arm off my nut and a stelly of vine in the bushes in the park. I'm off my nut. No more requests, please, thank you. The reason why, I don't mean to sound unappreciative, and then I'm doing requests half-heartedly, but see when a day like, could you do this voice? Could you do this, say this thing for a sketch that you did like say 5 years ago, 10 years ago or something? See if my heart's no in it. I can't fake it and I can't do it. It would be bad for the stream. It would be bad for the stream. I would rather come across as a bit of a dickhead and sort of no do it than what would happen to me if I had to keep doing it. You wouldn't like it, honestly. You really wouldn't like it. You wouldn't like it. Wormgory and Jacob Roy, thanks for subs and bits. How did Mr. Mulvaney come about? I just thought about... I think I liked the idea of somebody still wanting to get up to mischief, or somebody a wee bit bored with life and just wanting to get up to mischief, even though they don't look the type. I've just like that. I'm kind of like that in my own head. Well, I seem all grown up, kinda, and a bit boring and things like that, but in my mind I still want to do, don't know, random acts of vandalism, or I've not quite grown up, so I wanted a character like that. You fucking arsehole, that was you. No, you, the driver there. Panglossius, thanks for 1,000 bits. Thank you very much. Mike Zombie Masher, thanks for 300 bits. Any chance of some kind of 3-2-1 nonsense? I never like doing 3-2-1 on demand. I hope yous don't mind. I know that's another kind of request that I've knocked back, but I can only do it when my heart's in it. And when my heart's not in it, my heart's not in it. You're going to have to move back, troops. I'm sorry, but you're going to have to fucking move back, dickhead. Because I've made a mistake. Are we back? That's it. Are we back? Back. Keep going. Keep going, dickhead. You go. That's not going to work. Keep going. Keep going. Keep fucking going. Move back. Move back. Okay, they're just watching. In fact, you know what? F7. Go here. Go take it to the garage. Take it to the nearest garage, because it's a wee bit fucked, actually. The engine's a bit fucked. Barnshaw, thanks to 500 bits. Hey Limey, can you do the There's No Role sketch, please? But on a serious note, what's the story behind you working with Slam on this world? Basically what I said in the thing last night, they liked my stuff or saw my records, so I wanted to promote the new single, they saw my stuff and they thought, ask him to do it. So that was it. And he emailed us, and then I went there and I came up with an idea. But I'll tell you more about that in a wee second, right? Chef Skinhead. Bone Machine, thanks to subs and bits. I saw you 3 years ago in Sheffield on the Daffy Stories Tour. Only seen an episode of Lemmy Show. We missed most of the show, but I saw the Q&A, which was amazing. You dealt with some of the very, very tough questions. Do you remember it? Now I know you're all about that, of course, but it's been a great 3 years of comedy, and now I'm grateful for the company during the lockdown period. Thank you very much, mate. It was actually, wasn't it 3 years, wasn't it? That was my, like, Daffy Stories was fucking, wait a minute. That would have been That's Your Lot. Sheffield was That's Your Lot. In fact, Sheffield was the Vines. Wait a minute, where did I go for Sheffield? Sheffield. Where did I go for Sheffield? Wait a minute. Stop. Sheffield, was that Shallot? Was it? The City Hall, that's right. That's right. That was the book. Right. Big square with the fountain, that's right, I remember. I remember. Chef Skinhead thinks of bits, you missed my supper. No, I got it there, sorry. Davidson, thanks for the bits, mate. I'm gonna keep on fucking trucking. The Torta girl thinks the 313 sub mucho amor is the Mexico. Is that lots of love from Mexico? Thank you very much. I'm Alex the Kid, thank you very much for the bits. IRL streams I will at some point, aye. What was I gonna say? I was asked, slam this world, aye. I've told you this story before, but I stopped drinking, at least my last hangover, the hangover that made me stop, was on the 7th of June 2004. No long after that, I had a hangover that seemed to last a fucking month. It was a general sheepishness, scared way, the terrors that almost lasted a fucking month. It was like I was fucking something, I don't know what the fuck it was, but it lasted for fucking ages. I was like scared. I don't know what it was. Like, there was, it was like something just got fucking, something happened in my fucking brain with the drinking. The level of drink I did there that particular weekend, or how close I came to killing myself or something, I don't know what the fuck it was. But I was, basically I felt utterly fucking humbled, was the feeling. I felt at the mercy of anybody that I spoke to for a month, that's how it felt. And I remember when I went for the wee meeting at Soma Records to talk about, like, whatever idea I had. I remember this feeling when I was gaining my idea. I thought, see, I remember this feeling, I was kind of, like, nervous. No nervous at all, I'm nervous to meet them. But just, I had no fucking spine, no backbone. I thought, I know I've said it on here before, but I thought, see if they say to me, see, instead of that idea, could you do this idea? And imagine they asked me to do something where they would give me half a day's money to do a month's worth of fucking work. I had that weight in me that I would have just been like, aye, alright, aye, I can do that, yeah. In fact, you're right, are you alright for doing this whole thing for a tenner? I was just fucking, it was a mad feeling. Scared. Then when I finally got around to filming it, that was like October. Right about my birthday when I shaved my hair off. But that's it growing in for about like 3 weeks or something, or a month. So that's probably like November or something. What the fucking way you eat? Dibble and Owen Kelly, thanks for the subs. Thank you very much, mate. Cork. quick chat about addiction. Oh, glad you like my stuff. I hope it fucking helps. Addiction's a bastard. A bastard to him. That's how I would start my self-help addiction book. Why do people keep saying very Moorish? Why do people keep repeating that Harry Enfield patter that he said about heroin in his live show 1990 fuck knows what? It's the same fucking pattern, they bother Reeves. It's the same fucking part you hear all the time, man. Peep Show. I first heard it in fucking Harry Enfield. You see, the thing about heroin is, oh, it's very Moorish and everybody's all laughing. That was 90... Before Peep Show. Harry Hill. Did I say Harry Enfield? Harry Hill first. I said Harry Enfield. Right, aye, that's my head fucked. Heavy Joe, thanks for the sub. Arn Mick, thanks for the sub there. Biggie Dog, thank you for the sub. Can I have a shout out for Disaster, please? A fantastic virtual reality streamer. Be bold. That's it. That's how it's done. That's it. Lady of Ice. Lady of Ice. Let me hear that right now. Oh. No. Quick. Escape. Fucking hell. Set again. There we go. Again. And. One there. Final one. They might do another one later. Well done. No, not again. Right, move on. Powerful, very, very powerful. Maybe too powerful, maybe takes away for the song, maybe too much power. You don't want to fuck up a song. It's good that a music video makes you think of a song, but I think all I think about that song is the knee hit. John Hammond, thanks for the sub. Thank you very much. Carter Group, thanks for 5,067 bits. Thank you very much. I fucking crashed the fucking lorry there. Thank you very much, Carpenter Group. Thank you very much. Okay, Jimmy Buffett and Hot Dog Spaghetti, Digital Digging and Pagan Poetry, Salt and Sauce, thanks for the subs and bits there. Cereal. What? Don't know about that name there. Cereal, thanks for the sub. Don't know about that name. Mini, thanks for the 2 month resub. S Club Auto, thanks for £3. It's great that you've made positive steps in moving on. The Twitch streams are great and I'm glad you genuinely get pleasure at doing it. Depression is a bastard, so thank you very much. Avenzi, thanks for the sub. Calibor, John Hammond, Spartan Mizzy, thanks again for the sub. Fucking missed my turn there, man. Bucharest! That's what me and Lynn were watching tonight, and Jane McDonald's weekend thing. She's in Romania. Very nice. Very nice. You see, I was looking at Bucharest and I thought that looks nice, but still, it just isn't enough. And it's dead important when you're a cunt like me to admit to yourself, even if it's just to yourself, even if you have to lie to the fucking world, at least be honest with yourself. Do you like it? I mean, the buildings are nice. Do you fucking... No, I don't care. Because I'm telling you, that sort of fucking shite. Oh, no, Kate, it's fine. I said my bit, it's fine. That sort of shite leads to you fucking drinking like fuck or getting addicted to fucking shite as you try and make yourself normal, if you know what I mean. Try and align yourself to everybody else's fucking experience. I'm out on a Friday night or a Saturday night, I never actually really like it that much. You know what I'm going to do then? I'm going to get steaming. Here's another idea, don't fucking go out. I mean, I know Nacon goes out now, I'm talking about, you know, if it wasn't for that. Muftak says, what's a dick tid? What's a dick tid? For fuck's sake, Muftak, is that the best fucking part you've got? And that's a fucking 18 monther, minimum. 18 fucking sub badge there. Because I said the word addicted and it's got dick in it. What's a dick tid? Is that it? Rattle Gennaro, fucking rattle him. That's not a threat, by the way, to rattle somebody. Just rattle him back, just rattle him. As in, say something that makes him go, no. Only you, tonight. Touching the nights. Get that knee fucking punched. Is it really a drop? Can you truly say it's a drop? Unless you've punched your knee. I don't think so. Your total weight is 27 tonnes. Excuse me. I mean, I know I've put on a wee bit with all coronavirus and all that. Cesar, salt and sauce, thanks to subs and bits for watching your last show with the TV licence. You've just got yourself grassed. Thanks for the bits, but you've just got yourself grassed. I signed a spec. Viv, thanks for gifting the subs here. Cesar. And Mr. My Spare, thanks for the subs. Gifting the subs. The Fungal Toes, thanks for the sub. I signed a deal with the BBC. They said, could you do us a wee favour? If anybody says to you on social media or just streams or whatever, we don't really know how it works, but if any of them say, oh, I managed to watch your show using a VPN, I'm not in the country, or I've not got a licence, could you please report them to us? We will be able to chase this up and get them prosecuted. So I'm doing that just now. I get £3 for everybody I grass in. Thank you. Might not sound like a lot, but grassed in about 30 people now, that's me eating up to about 100 quid. The difference between Euro Truck Simulator 2 and American Truck Simulator is there's a lot of this. A lot of twists and turns, stopping at checkpoints and all this sort of carry on because you're going through Europe. Isn't it fucking amazing how many languages and cultures and all the rest of it there is in Europe? You would think to yourself, I mean, it does look wee on a map, but it is quite big. You would sort of imagine, like, say, the French language going through France all the way out to, say, Germany, and then, like, something like, I don't know, the rest of it's Polish or something like that. To have the French language, Spanish, Portuguese, German, Dutch, Italian, Greek. Norwegian, Swedish, Danish, yes, I know they're slightly similar. Flemish. Then, moving eastward, Romanian, Latvian, Lithuanian, I believe, Polish, Estonian, Slovenian, Serbo-Croat. All these fucking languages. Turkish, Irish, Gaelic, English, Welsh. Cornish, Sicilian, Basque. Incredible. What's my point? My point is, it's amazing. Esperanto. That's that made up one, isn't it? Moorish. Come here, you. I'm going to let you away because you're not a red motor, but believe me, if you were a red motor, mate, I would be fucking effed. I would be dumping my trailer to speed myself up and I'd be fucking coming for you. In fact, you know what, dickhead? I'm going to leave you. I'm going to leave you. You're lucky. Oh. Believe me, mate, if you thought that was me getting you there, you've never seen me get a red motor. You've never seen me get a fucking caravan, mate, if you think that was me getting you there. You ain't seen nothing. As they say in the States, I went to America once. A few things I want to say, everything's bigger there. Another thing they say is, have a nice day. Another thing they say in America is, you ain't seen nothing yet. And it means you've not seen anything yet, meaning, like, you know, something, there's something bigger, like, yet to come or something. See, when you go to America, see the cafes there, they fill up your coffee. The coffees they drink, you know, they don't drink tea there, it's coffee. And they keep topping it up. See, when you run out, they top up, it doesn't cost anything extra. I've never seen anything like it. And they're really into getting their teeth done. Or them perfect teeth. One last wee fact for you. You know what money they've got there? It's not pounds, dollars. The currency's called dollars. Roby, Funnycom, thanks for the subs and bits. Just saw Lemmy's other stuff, good stuff. Can't believe how different you look in the LED sketch. Maybe it's the beard. Aye, the hair was all dark, the beard's all dark, the grey. Thinner. Yes, we'll change. Rab, thanks for the 5-month-3 sub. Struggles booking a COVID test. Good luck. I hope you get the result you want, if you know what I mean. Fucking kill. Out of way, copy. Yes, man, nobody saw him. I was away for the cameras. Nobody saw him. Nobody saw a thing, man. One in. Hey. Oh, what you look at? How do you not pronounce Aaron? Mirror. So what you want to do is take your mirror, look in your mirror. Hello Riot, can I get a shout out for Riot Bananas, another fantastic virtual reality streamer currently. Mirror. So take your mirror and your parmesan and your herbs, place them on your mirror. Take your herbs and parmesan, place them on your mirror. Jose Santana, thanks for 200 bits. Have you ever heard how Americans pronounce the name Aaron? How did it do it? I take it. What did it do? Aaron. So if I looked up somebody saying like Elvis Aaron Presley, they would say Aaron. Aaron. I knew a lassie called Aaron. A lassie in Millport called Aaron that I got off with when I was like a teenager, and I couldn't remember it because I was fucking steaming. So I got up to the last day, you got off with Aaron? Did I? No, I didn't. Get off with it, it's just kissing. No, it's kissing. What? What? And I was like, couldn't remember it. Just blanked it. Then I bumped into her. I don't know if I asked her. I don't think I got off her again. But I think I asked her next day. I said, did I get off of you last night? Aye. All right. But I bumped into her years later, when I went down to Millport for a cycle, just chatting away. Dee dee dee. Mute and Roby, thanks for the subs. Pat and Kieran, thanks for the 200 bits. Thank you very much. Do you just drive about, ask Jerry? Drive about and chit chat? Drive about, chit chat. Let me look up American saying Bernard. Bernard. Is that not the name of the guy in, what's his name? Westworld. Got a Saint Bernard. Hello. Hello, Rexit. Who's that good boy? Such a good natured dog. Such a good natured dog. I should have went to that wee bit for a sleep there. Such a really well behaved dog. Good boy. Good boy. Lovely dog. Little fluffy cloud and G-Man Grey, thanks for the subs. Touching the night. Fucking get that red motor bastard, I need to turn. Oh wait. You turn? No. Fuck. Only you. Here, I wonder what game I'll get for Monday. Let's get a new game for Monday, everybody. Don't suggest a game in the chat. No point in suggesting a game in the chat. I'm not going to read it. Not going to remember it. Even if I read it, I'm not going to remember it. There are walking sim suggestions in the Discord, in the walking sim suggestions, because that's what I'm looking for. First person walking sims, kind of like your Firewatch, your What Remains of Edith Finch. You're walking about, preferably voice actors, looking about, trying to uncover some sort of some story sort of progresses. Disney lasts too long, lasts about 4 hours or so. Going home, I've played them all. Don't bother suggesting them here. Simply take the game that you think is a walking sim, first person walking sim. Go to my Discord, please. Go to the channel that says Walking Sim Rex, short for recommendations, and simply paste that Steam link directly in. You don't need to talk about it. You don't need to discuss other people's suggestions. Just paste it in and walk away. And I'll take it for there, and I'm very grateful for your suggestion. If you find yourself typing, not quite a walking sim, but this is, stop right there. Hit backspace. And leave. Cabbage. Right, I need to sleep here. Hold on. I need to go for a wee sleep. High risk. High reward. The risk of death. The reward of a rush of endorphins in the brain. Oh, hold on. Cabbage, thanks for the 500 bits. Unexpectedly enjoying my 40th. thanks to my buddies, you and Troops. Thank you very much. Good, happy birthday. Happy birthday there. Unexpectedly. Pat and Kieran, thanks to 200 bits there. Tenigbs, thanks for the 2 month resub. 2 months of bantering fucking memes, man. Thank you very much. Touching the night. It doesn't go night, it goes touching the night. Smell like that. Was Kevin Bacon, I think I've asked this before, was Kevin Bacon in Footloose meant to be good looking? I went the wrong way. Yeah, he was. Aye. There's certain 80s looks. See that guy that I just showed you? That Touching the Night one? He's got a kind of... I remember there was certain... There were certain guys like in my school when I was younger or something. There was like a certain look. That would be fanciable back then. Where the fuck am I going here? Wait, hold on. Where have I go? And then it's like tastes change. It's not just good looking, isn't it, enough? It's got to be a kind of a certain style of good looking. Wait, where the fuck am I? What am I doing here? What am I doing here? Turn around. Get out of here. Get out of here. Oh, you fucking mug. You fucking mug. You what? You've a fucking scene, alright? You've a fucking scene, alright? John Boss and Super King Legend, thanks for the subs. I don't know, you were fucking seen, alright? I remember that. Where the fuck have I go? Are there? Have I go? Have I go? What? Right, stop. Right. What? Well, where have I go? That's like if you're coming. Hey. Oh fuck. Inconsistent. Poison for Cuzco and Finlay, thanks for the subs there, thank you very much. What was I talking about? What was I talking about there? No, there was something after the attractive 80s guys on the show. Something else. What was it? Can't remember fuck all. Like Kevin Bacon. Kevin Bacon by the... I'll never forget that I lost the plot whilst watching the music video for Heaven Helps the Man, I'm Free by Kenny Loggins for Footloose when I was in Sheffield, I think. That whole wanking session I had. And it wasn't because I was wanking there. Because I wasn't. I tell you. It's wanking there, bullseye. No wank near it. Wank coincidentally to it. Anyway. Where was I? remember telling you before, it was mad. I've got a habit of, I'm borderline off my fucking nut. The other night, actually, I was lying in bed and I felt myself slightly detached from reality a wee bit. I don't know what the fuck it was, but it was almost like the way I was in my teenage years, my late teens. Like, with all this sleeping too much and stuff, like, I would sleep like fuck. Like Dee Dee. And I'm not talking about later on with the sunflower pictures, which was in my 20s, when I felt that evil presence. But just, my pals would sort of think I was mental. It's just interesting in your own fucking head. But the other day, what was the thing? I was lying in bed thinking something. I don't know. Semi-insane thoughts. Can't remember what it was. But it's mad. It's funny. It kind of feels like, I don't even know what the fuck it was, but I was like, oh. Nothing scary. Nothing made me go like, oh, this is. It was like, it was almost like a wee, like getting into an old comfy pair of fucking slippers. It was all good, man. Going back to the old days of being off my fucking nut. But that time in Sheffield, it was in a hotel all day and night. And I had this song, I would play this song, Heaven Helps a Man, I'm Free. Or I'm Free, whatever it is, Kenny Loggins. Dun 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 dun. Do 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 do. Something about that just so atmospheric, and I was watching the music video and I was trying to get that bit. Remember I showed you that there's that bit for the, not the music video, but there's that bit for that bit in Footloose and the music video, where they've managed to get the disco up and running and all that. And I was looking at Kevin Bacon, I was looking at the lassie. And I was looking at the pals and all that, and the kind of ex-boyfriend, and the dancing in the wee town, and it started to feel fucking real, and I felt like I was somehow a part of it. I don't know, it was fucking mad. I just had this feeling. Sometimes I think about something enough, I feel like I could be insane, I think is the word. On you go. I'm complaining. Because that's fucking disgraceful. I've just got 10% damage to my. Like, I remember, I don't know if I told you, but. I've told you before. I think I've told you before on the stream. Slayer 7 Things to Turn a Bits. You ever get that thing where you'd feel detached from yourself and everything seems like it's really far away? Sometimes, definitely get it from meditating, but that's deliberate. But that's got a name, isn't it? The Bulginator and Cabbage. Thanks for the subs and gifted subs. Thank you very much. Your Slender Boy. Thanks for the sub. Like, I remember getting this feeling, I've spoke about it before, but I may as well, disassociation or something. Like, I'm no nostalgic, I used to be really nostalgic looking back. And, like, especially about Millport, when I started getting into my, like, later teens and 20s and I wasn't like a teenager anymore, carefree, I was like working, and then I'd sort of look back and I'd be drinking and going, oh god, that'd be good to just go back to them when I had just all the time in the world and all that. But I don't know if I told you, but Millport. Where was it that I went? There's a bit back here. There's probably no here anymore, but. No way. Can you get in there? No, you can't. The pictures here. Aye. Up here, everybody. There's the front bit at Millport, right? Up here was the cinema. Up here was the pictures. See this here? That's your pictures there. Millport Library. You what? Town Hall, right? That was the fucking cinema. I went in that place to watch fucking Neverending Story by myself when it came out. Quite a sad fucking childhood, sort of. Lonely childhood. Sort of. At least in my head. And then, remember I told you before, when I got to about 14, 15, I bumped into here. I would come down every summer, sort of spend a lot of time just by myself. Then I came down when I was about 14, 15, and I bumped into a guy that I knew fell up the road back in Glasgow. I was like, what the fuck are you doing here? Like, they used to all drink and stuff like that. Because I'd been coming down here every year. I was like, what? Well, I'm introduced you to every cunt. And we all fucking met up and had like a big group of pals and all the rest of it. Everybody was fucking brand new. Everybody was pure fucking decent. As opposed to up the road where he's alright, he's sort of a bit, he's alright, but he's fucking stupid. He's alright, he's a, every cunt was pure brand new. And I was like, this is fucking it, alright. It was excellent. Right now, speaking about it, I don't really feel it. See, if you spoke to me 10 years ago, I would really feel it. I would go, it was really, really good, and that's why I did that Millport sketch. That there was where the disco used to be, in there. And I remember telling you about this before, but I remember thinking about this that much, like, years after, when it was all sort of gone. When I'd grown up, I thought, could I, like, pine for the fucking years so much, the carefree sort of years so much, that I could actually come here? Like, at fucking night time, in a rainy night, as a guy in his, like, 30s or fucking 40s, long after the years have gone, and, like, be here, we're drinking me. And imagine myself back there so fucking much that I can insane myself into it fucking feeling real. Do you know what I mean? I mean, I know insane isn't a fucking verb. Like, could I imagine it so much that it's as good as being real? Could you trick your mind that much, consciously? And it just being real? I mean, is it fucking possible? I just thought about it. I didn't really want it, but I just thought, is it possible? But anyway, I remember coming down maybe about 5 years ago or something like that, on a big cycle. Cycled all the way to Largs. I know I've said this before, right? Cycled all the way, if you Glasgow to Largs, then you get the ferry across, came all the way around, whole things took fucking ages, 30 miles or something. And I remember I went, we used to drink round the back there, behind there. They called it the slab. It's kind of like that ramp there, right? I went and took a picture and everything. It's kind of like that wee ramp there, but it's kind of round the back and a lot weirder. We'd sort of have a wee drink round the back, we'd go into the disco and all that, we'd all be a bit drunk. And I came down one summer, like 5 years ago, when I was like in my fucking 40s, still in my 40s. I mean, I'm 45 now, but I mean, I don't think it was like 39 or something. And I went round the back, I was cycling, and it was nice and sunny. And everything's all different, people with families, I tend 10:30 definitely. I was down by myself this time though, and I went round the back there with my bike, and I was hearing people sort of dotted about and all that, just in the distance, and I was there looking at that place. What does it look like on a map? What does it actually fucking look like? Satellite 40. How'd you get that up again? Satellite. Da, na, 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 na. That there, really. That fucking there. That there is all I'm talking about. That there. That right there. And I went there and I was on my bike. But it's like 2 in the afternoon or something like that. It was all sunny. And I was just kind of looking at it. And I know I've spoke about this before, right? But I was just kind of looking at it. And did I get this feeling before? I can't remember if I did it twice, right? But I went there and I was looking at this place, and I don't know if I did this twice or if I had the same feeling on the same journey, but I was looking at this place. We used to have a drink and a laugh and all that, and it was like some laugh, right? And I remember having this feeling I could almost sort of see myself there in the past when I was like 15 or so, and I was thinking, look at this. I'm looking at this place, and the me from the past doesn't know that I'm standing here right now in the future with my bike, reminiscing. It was weird, and it felt kind of sad and sort of pathetic. And I can't remember if I felt this next feeling at the same time, like just after, or if I came down on another trip, like say about a few months later. But I remember being there and looking at it and trying to, why is it sad and pathetic? Because I'm like there, like, what am I doing there? Instead of just getting on with my life. But the feeling was, I was wanting to really feel something. I know that sounds all kind of nice and all that. That's weird that the me for the past doesn't know that I'm standing right here as a ghost. It's kind of like, see me right now. There's almost like a ghost for the future, possibly standing right here, looking at this room for the last time before I leave the house, imagine a move house or something like that, right? Or Glasgow or some place or something. Fucking present. No for the past, but for the fucking future in a sense, right? You get the feeling this is you right here and now, and it is. But at some point you're going to be looking back at this. I'm going to be looking back at this hairline and going like that. Okay, I thought this was fucking bad. I'm going to be looking back at this and going, I'm going to be thinking back at this hairline going, I thought this was fucking bad. Hello to the future me, by the way. Look at this. Look. Look. Look at this. You thought this was bad. You thought that was bad. You thought that was fucking bad. You had no fucking idea. Eh? Get fucking steady. You don't suit it. You shaved it off. You don't suit it. You don't suit yourself with hair. You don't suit it with it. You don't suit it with it. You're fucked. That's a funny wee rhyme there. But all joking aside, you're fucked. You're a fucking mess. I was looking at that place, trying to feel something. I thought that was a nice wee kind of almost science fictiony sort of fucking thought I had, right? But I was looking at this place that I used to go, and I was wanting to feel a very powerful fucking emotion of yearning for that time. Or Christ, it's no science fiction. That's what I said. I think science fictiony. Science fiction, add a Y onto the word at the end of any word, gets you, you can get out of anything. It's no science fiction, I said science fiction, eh? Sorta, kinda. But I was looking at it trying to, I thought, I wonder if I just meant it's real. Well, it's not, because I'm not really a ghost for the future. In a way, and that's why I said science fiction-y. So I was standing there, and the reason why I thought I would go there is to see if I could see what would happen, see if I got this intense, you've sort of got, unless you've got sort of like, maybe spiritual sort of beliefs, that kind of thing. I wanted to be there to see if I would feel this intense kind of nostalgia or something, right? No, sure, right. I've had this sort of feeling of like looking at it and going, fucking hell, it's mad. That's mad, that. You know, like if you smell something, smell an old fucking classroom or something, or something, and you're like, sometimes see if I walk past a doorway that's got metal fences outside, metal fence, and then it goes in and there's a door and there's a hedge, I'm like, I'm just reminded of some house or something like that when I was younger, or like I used to walk by these houses and I'm like, you know, like it's fucking mad. I was wanting to get that same feeling like with this. And I was there. And what I got, the feeling I got, was I realised that I didn't actually fucking care anymore. I used to care. I used to care about, you know, the nostalgic feeling. I used to sort of care about it, and I didn't anymore. So in a way, I wasn't just looking into my the old me as a teenager when I was 15, hanging about there. I was standing there, looking at the old self that used to care about that, the nostalgia, and I was just kind of standing there, like thinking about it with my bike, thinking, I'm almost like fucking casting my mind back to when I was the sort of person who used to cast his fucking mind back, and I was standing there like that, I don't give two fucks about this, I don't care, I've got no feeling about this. And I think that's when I got that feeling, seeing myself when I was a 15-year-old, and it's almost like behind a fucking wall of glass, and just going, that one of the past is just getting on with it, unaware of it all, and I'm standing here looking, and I don't even feel anything. And I thought to myself, why are you even here reminiscing about being 15 when you actually came down here right into your, like, to the age of 20 when your mom died, you sold the wee house in the caravan that was there, you came down once or twice and stayed with one or two people after it, you were down here after it, you know, it's not like you were 15 and then you left this place and that's the last memory you've got of it, you came down for about another 5-6 years, you didn't come round to this fucking bit. You fucking idiot. And I was just standing there like, sorry to hear about your mother, mate. Sorry, no bother, Jerry. Coming for 26 years ago, mate, I'm kinda healed up pretty well, mate. Time out, Val's like, time out, ban him, get him banned. So I didn't feel anything, other than that, and I think that's why I'm one of the reasons why I'm happy to let the telly stuff go and all the rest of it, is because I don't actually quite fucking like it, and I'm no I mean, I don't like the hard work involved. Let me get back to driving. I kind of have a feeling I'm not going to waste my fucking life looking back at it, looking back to something. It's not like a decision to move on or anything like that. It's just like, I really don't fucking care about anything. A lot of things in my past anymore. The telly stuff, really that much. The old stuff when I was a teenager, my 20s. I've got this kind of feeling that I'm at the end of my life. The second half, which I'm. And then end of the first off, I want to do something different now. You know how normally, like, what would be expected of me right now, maybe is, or what I would expect of myself. PogChamps and Dalpinator, thanks to the subs, gift subs. I have severe mental health issues. I'm under a bit of nostalgia a lot too. Thank you for being making me feel seen. Oh, you're welcome. That's what I'm saying. I like fucking jabbing on about myself, and if any cunt gets any sort of help for me rabbiting on about myself, then that's fucking magic. Colin and Harambe Fergus Bradders, thanks for the subs. Back at work, so missing my streams during the weekdays. I'm fucking here now. Right, listen. Like, what you'd maybe expect? Hold on a minute. Hold on. Got that too loud. There you go. Everybody, Kate, Kate's just removed a button. Ever forgiven, Kate. What would be expected of me, or what I'd normally expect of myself if I was me, let's say 5, 10 years ago, is for me to continually do telly stuff or telly related stuff for as long as I can until I'm absolutely fucking shite. Like, I'm always involved in some sort of program stuff, or getting in touch with commissioners or production companies and trying to get something happening and all that. And because I did DD, Jack McCaffrey and Falconhoof, I kind of try and dine out on that for the rest of my fucking days. In a way, I kind of am here. Would yous all be here if I wasn't originally the cunt for Limmy Show? I don't think so. I think it helps. Maybe, absolutely not. Maybe. No chance. Right. It's because he's maybe know the other stuff, or not because of that, but because then you find out about the other stuff or something like that, right? And you go, oh, he's a clever clogs, I like him. He's clever. He's funny. Anyway, you'd expect me to like continually do, right? Let's see if I can do a fucking Limmy Show. I'm very clever. Yes, I am, Kate. Yes, thank you very much. You would expect me to then see if I can do like a sitcom, or like write a novel, or do one of these usual fucking things. If you've written short stories, you want to then write a novel. If you've done a sketch show, you want to then keep having an attempt at doing a sitcom. Get past the fucking knockbacks and daymare. Maybe even see if you can do a film. Maybe see if you can act in something. Something related to being in front of the camera, or writing, or like films, telly, something like that. And see, just gone like that. No. And then this. That's all right. it feels fucking magic. It feels like a new life. And I know that these things, you get a buzz about something and then the buzz fades. Everything new will eventually feel old. Then what do you do? This doesn't actually feel that new to me. This doesn't feel new. Hold on, there's a dick, hold on, let me get a stickhead here. Fuck off. Fuck. Hey, fuck you. Fucking magic. Such a lucky, privileged position to just be able to settle right into this. Coming on, like right here. And talking about the, chanting about telling these wee stories that I've fucking told about a million fucking times. And I try and sort of like, hit it with a disclaimer. Well, I know I've said it, I know I've already said it. Well, you have already said it, see, because you've already said it, gonna no fucking say it again, I won't fucking say it again. I know I've already said this, that's right, so you don't need to say it again. No, but I want to. Let him tell his wee story. Let him tell, oh sorry mate. Let him tell his wee story, it's just, it settles him down. It settles him down. Only you. Istanbul, everybody, we're here. Da-na-na. Da-na-na. Getting to come on and just chit-chat away. Exactly, Chris, a bit. I've always just loved sitting here. Chit-chatting away. Talking a lot of shite. Chit-chatting away, hold on. Watch yourself. Watch yourself. Whoops. Anyway, maybe I get that wee scratch fix. You can get stuff that you can kind of, there's stuff you can sort of put on the scratches. You know, you won't have to go to a garage or anything like that. Just like kind of ink. Like book polish.
Wreck off, copy.
Only Ogre's Latrine thinks of 200 bits. Arrow Grammar, thanks for gifting that sub. Put a donk on it, thanks for the sub. My girlfriend wants to know if you've tried a marshmallow ice in the Ritz Cafe. I don't think so. I've had the standard ice cream, Knickerbocker Glory, so on and so forth. Just, I'm in a hurry, just, you fucking do it, go. You do it. Gaggle Scone, a sweaty Bossack, Bezos Sack, thanks for gifting his subs, thanks for the subs. Matslow, thanks for £3. So I had a question, the TV stuff and the Twitch life are two very different things, but you do not miss the creative process of creating sketches and characters, like how you started it, how do you fill that creative void? I don't miss it because I fucking hated it. Hello, Funk the Void. I fucking hated it. Alright. There you go. I hated it. I hated it. And I fucking hate you. Where's France? Everybody? We're going to Strasbourg. Strasbourg. No. That's a joke, by the way. I don't hate you. Metz. We're going to Metz in France. No. Let's go. No. Oh, fuck. No, I didn't mean that. Right. Job market. I told my girl, bye-bye, and I really didn't mean it. Right, we're going to Strasbourg. We're going to France, everybody. Get to France. Ben, you know that song? Get to France. Do you know that? Mike Oldfield. First time. Final countdown reaction. No. Mike Oldfield. Get to France. What's her name? Scottish. Maggie Riley. Aye, click on that, click on that, click on that. Fuck, hold on. Maggie. Glasgow or East Coast or something, Maggie Riley. I'm gonna bet Glasgow, man. I'm gonna bet Glasgow, go give me Glasgow. Moody's Burn. I bet she was just born there. She was brought up in Glasgow. Come on. Moody's Burn. Where's that then? Kind of central? Where's that then? Moody's Burn. Do-do-do-do. Glasgow, Edinburgh, so like kind of there's Glasgow. It's like about like Glasgow. Dum-dum-dum-dum-dum. So like about a fifth of the way to Edinburgh. Kind of, alright, so it's like 3/4 of the way for Glasgow to come on out. Right, so that's pretty much Glasgow. Do you younger people know that? Get to France. That's a way to say people get to fuck. You're not actually saying it to a French person. There wasn't any French people, any French people. Then Harry D is a very obese man. Can you give him motivation now because you're trying to slag your pal off, you arsehole? There you go. Put on a wee bit. Put on a wee bit. Put on a wee bit. Put on a wee bit.
Represented a human. If you can listen, the put piano on a bit. Is going like a heartbeat.
Put on a wee bit, mate.
Later on.
Hold on. Where's it going? Where's it going? His mic fell off. See, Mike's alright. Mike's alright. Look at me, his bare feet and all that. Look, fucking house next to the beach and all that. Look, look at this. Look at that.
There's the guitar. I missed it, you see.
Who the fuck films in barefoot him? Put it on a wee bit. Dun, 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 dun. Put it on a bit.
So interesting, a balloon's texture.
Right, put it on, put it on, put it on. Put it on, put it on. That's the way I want now. That's some there, look.
How do you find a dunes?
That's some there.
How do you find a kind of climax point?
Right, go on, go on, go on. Let me show you one other thing. I want to show you. Right, fuck that, just get on it, just get on it. Wait, you see this? Do you know the song On the Run by Pink Floyd? I love this because Dave Gilmour is showing you the wee synth, and he looks like an old sort of grander, showing you this basically fucking like the dawn of fucking techno. Sorry. Let's get down to business. Back to business. Back to business. Let's get back to the business of deliveries, everybody. Right? Pink Tories, what does that mean? Let's get back to the very real, very serious business of deliveries. Hello, Rexa. You're a good boy. Really lovely, good-natured dog, Brexit. Unlike Brexit, Brexit, lovely, lovely, good-natured, well-natured. Such a lovely. Wait. Where am I going here? Right, I shouldn't be going this way. Jenny K, thanks for gifting that sub. Kiri Weary, Geo Holmes, thanks for the 200 bits. Thanks again. Marty Wilson, Braxton, Disintegration Loops, thanks. You're welcome. Sorry, not sorry. Any more episodes, the Lummies, all stuff? That's a lot. Fogmaster Fresh and Embleman, thank you very much. Thank you very much. We are the fucking boys. Thank you very much. I feel like putting some new things on my steering wheel, but not tonight, not tonight. See if you ever hear me say, not tonight, not tonight. I'm quoting the song The Bouncer by Kicks Like a Mule. Miss Bits from Beirut. Thank you very much, Beirut. Please go to Metz, that's where I'm from. By the way, it's pronounced Mess. Alright. Electricary, Sponge McClunge and Shitewing. Thanks for the subs. Thank you very much. Well, I'll see if I can go, right? But I have decided to go to this. My steward bits. Okay. Well done. Oh, can we get a shout out for mod Alice Astro, who's just recently started streaming? Aye, big fucking shout out, Alice Astro. Can I say, everybody, listen, listen. Now, I've sometimes got a habit of raiding the same sort of people again and again, the same sort of collection of, say, six or seven people, right? Remember, I've got a self-promo text channel on my Discord server. If you're a streamer and you like coming on here and you're one of the people that sort of come on here and you want to sort of post in there, tell everybody about your stream, right? And I'll try and remember to give you a follow. Because I'm always looking for new people to go and visit. I don't want to just go into the usual, like, random people on Twitch. I don't know what they're like. But see, if you're in my Discord and you're posting in the self-promo thing and I give you a follow, then, you know, I might give you a raid. I know that sounds very... Oh, it might be your lucky day getting a raid off of me. But... it's just a good way for me to know that the chances are you're an alright person, because the fact is, if you like me and you think I'm funny, it doesn't guarantee you're a good person or you're a person that I would like, but it does increase the chances. I've got a right weakness for people who like me. Somebody thinks I'm funny, I think they can't be all bad. Can't be all bad. Hear that rain? Bus. Thanks for the bits. How many people have you blinded with a bloody truck? It would be good if you could cause crashes by shining the light in their faces. So I'm just driving somewhere to then do the delivery. It's teeming it down here. It's fucking pissing down there. Wish I was in a tent right now, it says Boompish. I prefer a house. Well, windy. See that? That's the roof there. So the wind is at a 45 degree angle, so you can hear the rain hitting against it. That's a nice sound. A tent would be nice and everything, but the downside is somebody could slice through the tent with a knife. Come and get you. G. Campbell, thanks to 300 bits. How did you think of the guy with the big ears that approaches with caution? Hold on, give us a second. How did you think of the guy with the big ears that approaches like, oh, he's not got big ears. I've just got the hoodie up and I poke my ears forward and I've not got big ears. My ears are too wee. My hearing's bad. I just thought about somebody coming into the house, but they're like looking about almost like, you know, like an animal. That was it. That was it, essentially. is fucking doing up at this time? 25 past one. Get the red motor. I pick my moments. I pick my battles. I pick my battles. Oh, crash into it. It's fine. It's fine. There you go. No damage when you crash into them. It's your turn for a long lie, disaster. Brilliant. Right, I'm going to need to go to a garage. This is fucked. This is wrecked. This is wrecked. Ten 30 says I'm rearranging a whole room too deep in, can't back out now, I'm fucked. Ah, that feeling. That old feeling, man. Once you've fucking done it, once you've started, I was like that with this here. See when I was like moving the desk, I think I was, see just as something as minor as moving the computer from underneath that desk just to my right to air there to the left, took fucking ages. Where I was going to put the cables, what I was going to attach them to, how I was going to like declutter it all, and where I'm going to put the light and all this sort of fucking shite. Horrific. And once you start you reach a point of no return. Morning Zaffa Cakes. Can I get a shout out for I had to look down to see what top I was on. Could I get a shout out for Zaffa Cakes, please? Fantastic. Manager of Pez United. No, everybody thinks that. Not everybody would agree. But well, but what? But what? You go, what are you gonna say, mate? Nothing. Thanks for the memories. It's time for you to fucking take a walk. Wait a minute. It's over. Jack and GSX, thanks for the subs and bits. Thanks for letting me know about the Discord, just up my channel and self-promo. Aye, batter it in there. You don't necessarily have to be streaming right now, just, you know, telling people, here's my channel, you want to give us a follow. Everybody, is everybody nice and relaxed tonight? That was me yawning. Hello Pink Hexagon, can I get a shout out for Pink Hexagon, everybody? Fantastic Just Chatting streamer. And can I just say, by the way, these people that I'm... Disaster says, any objection to me ripping your sound clouds and trying to mix them on a VR DJ table? You fucking go for it and do what you want. Can I just say, by the way, Pink Hexagon and these other people that I've mentioned that are actually real people? The cases are real. The courtroom is real. The decisions are final.
and it's touchdown. John, what do you think of this play here? I've not seen this since 92 in Wisconsin and the playoffs.
10:30 says, Lemmy, we were discussing in Hexy's team if we read our phones when taking a shite. Of course. I'm in the toilet for probably 10 times longer than what I used to be due to having a mobile. Did I tell you? Lynn recently told me that she's got a pal. She went out one night and she was chatting to her, like, pals that she knows from when she was younger. And she said, oh, wait, you hear this? I think I maybe told you this, I don't know. Wait, you hear this? Her pal said that she does this thing if she goes to a toilet in a pub. If she does a shite, she walks out of the pub toilet looking at her phone as if to show people, strangers, that the reason why she was in for so long is because she happened to be, like, on her phone. It wasn't because she was doing a shite. And Lynn was pissing herself, and I said, that's what I do. JKLP Racing, Hector McBreath, thanks to the subs. Not tonight. You just know that song, didn't you? The bouncer kicks like a mule. No? It's about no getting into a club. Kicks like a mule, the bouncer.
We, the people.
For the people.
People.
The people.
People.
We are brave.
We're bold. We are red, white, blue, and gold.
Just show me your clothes, tell me how much they cost. Just show me your clothes, tell me how much they cost. Simple as that. Don't act like you give a fuck about fucking any cunt.
Your name's not down, you're not coming in. Your name's not down, you're not coming in. Not tonight, not tonight.
That's a song. That's a song.
Your name's not down, you're not coming in.
That's a song. Let's put it on a wee bit. Where we go?
Your name's not down, not tonight.
Not tonight. Not tonight. Many times I heard that, man. I've never made jungle, no.
Your name's not down, you're not coming in.
No, not tonight. Not tonight. Not tonight, boys. Not tonight, lads.
Tonight, you're not on the list.
I've never been hit with any list, but not tonight, aye. Not tonight. Not tonight.
Your name's not down, you're not coming in.
Right, I want to go to the end bit after this, right?
Not tonight, you're not on the list.
Here we go. And if I remember correctly, Look, mate, I've told you once, I've told you twice, you're not in the list, alright.
Listen, mate, I've told you once.
Is it listen, mate? I want to skip that again.
Listen, mate, I've told you once, I've told you twice, you're not on the list, alright.
I've told you once, I've told you twice.
Listen, mate, I've told you once, I've told you twice, you're not on the list, alright.
A whole song called The Bouncer, man. A whole song called The Bouncer.
Your name's not down, you're not coming in.
You're not coming in, that's your night fucking ruined.
Your name's not down, you're not coming in.
That's your night fucked. But my pals are in there. Not tonight.
Not tonight, not tonight.
But my pals are in there. Not tonight. You're a fucking arsehole. I was just about to let you in there. That's a classic. Just about to let you in there as well. That's a classic, man. Lewis and Loathsome Greg. Thanks for the subs. Your name's not Dan, you're not coming in. Your name's not Dan, you're not coming in. Listen, mate, I've told you once, I've told you twice, you're not in the list, alright. Rory Hannah, thanks for the sub. Shout out to your what pal Jamie, who has stayed late to help you. Thank you, Jamie, for helping out Rory Hannah. Thank you very much. On behalf of the team, thank you. It's just rib. Hey, Lemmy, how's Euro Truck Simulator? I'm thinking about getting the game. I just tuned in now. You fucking liar. Why don't you watch it, you absolute liar? Did you fuck just tune in? How's this game? Why don't you watch it? Why don't you watch it? I'm no you. I've not got the same brain as you. What I like, you might know. That's why some people like a film and another one, isn't it? What I think of this game, isn't it? What you'll fucking think. Now watch the fucking game, watch me play it, and go, I think that's something I would like. Or, this looks a lot of shite. You Brian Lemon. Everybody, I think it's really good because there's new people that are following the channel, new people that are coming in. Some of yous might need a patter update or patter explainer. You might go, what is this? What is it when he goes like this? Is your name Brian Lemond? I once went to a dance festival called Homelands Scotland. It was up in Aberdeen, and that was when I was about 28, maybe 27, can't remember. And I was mad with it. I was taking drugs. G Campbell, thanks for 300 bits, why don't you do the West Highland Way? Did. Sorta. Kiki, thanks for gifting that sub there. It's just rib, it's just a joke, by the way. See what I was saying before? That's just a joke, it's just part. I'm real suave, thanks to 200 bits, all time favourite games. I have to tap my head, Return of the Obra Dinn. Beans Grant, thanks for the sub, that's you back, thank you very much, welcome back. So, everybody was away, we're all mad with it. And then it's kicking out time, whenever the fuck that was, 4 in the morning, 5 in the morning, 6 in the morning, I can't remember. It was like it was a dead late one. 2004 or something like that, or 2003 or something. Anyway, we had to wait for a few hours until the fucking trains were on. So we're just sort of kicking about Aberdeen doing fuck all. Pure Cumden, you just want to be in your bed, but you're fucking miles away from Glasgow. Got on the train, and every cunt is all looking all run down. Everybody was at like Homeland Scotland, and everybody's like, fucking hell man, I wish everybody would just fuck off. Right? So everybody's sitting on the train. I was sitting next to Lynn, right? And there were two seats in front of us. You know, all the seats are all kind of facing one way, and then you occasionally get tables. I was sitting next to Lynn. Just like, you know, it's all fucking like, the, you know, the sun's up, it's dawn, it's like 8 in the morning or whatever fucking time it was, I don't know, 7 when the train started. Horrible feeling, horrible come down feeling. Because it wasn't just eckies, it was this other stuff like paste. It was like, I think it was like some mad fucking concentrated fucking amphetamine shite. I don't know what the fuck it was we took. But the come down wasn't pretty. You're just wanting to be back in your bastard and fucking bed. And so you're just sitting there like that, like, fucking get this train moving, man. Like, you know, the train takes about 3 hours or 4 hours, I can't remember. 3 hours maybe for Aberdeen to Glasgow or something. I just fucking hurry up, man. Just sitting there looking at the window. You're no wanting to make eye contact with any cunt. Just like that. And then I hear one loudmouth yapping away at people. I was like, this cunt, man. Fucking hell. And then I happened to sort of look here and I recognised the guy. I was like, I fucking know that guy, man. Like, I know that guy for Hill Park, a place in Glasgow where I used to go to school and then hang about when I was like early teens. Mid-teens, and I was like, oh fuck, he was like about a year older than me, he was just sort of there, I didn't pure hang about with him, you know, like there's like groups of people that sort of go, aye, sort of chat, aye, and then sort of part company. I was like, I fucking know him, I think his name was Marty, or Martin. I was like, fuck, I know him, he knows me, and he's one of these ones that's gone like that. I thought, like, if he fucking sees me, man, if he sees me and wants me to start speaking to him, when every cunt is on the fucking train, all in a condon, all like this. And this is before the telly stuff and all the rest of it, so it's not like anybody would be going like that, there's Lemmy. But you know that everybody's just tuning in, everybody's just tuning in, and you don't want anybody tuning into you. You're no here, you just want to vanish, you're no here. Everything is just an ordeal. I thought this cunt's going to start speaking to me. So I just went, oh, fuck. I just went like that, right? I just kind of shut my eyes. He was sort of every now and again, kind of walking about, I think, and I was like, just. And then at some point, I don't know, I was just sort of looking out the window and then talking to Linden again and then looking out the window and that's it. And then I think I had my eyes shut for a bit, right? And I looked like that, I looked, and he was sitting on one of the seats with his feet out in the aisle. You know, sort of like, just sort of like leaning out like that. And he was like that. You know, he'd clocked me. Right, he'd sort of clocked me and I just kind of went like that for a wee second. Looked at the window, right? No, he'd seen me. Like, fuck, right. And then I fucking shut my fucking eyes. I was like, fuck, that's like a fucking. Lynn was like, started to speak to me and I was like, don't speak to me. There's a guy that recognises me and I was like, what's that? Shh, there's a guy that recognises me and I don't want him fucking to start, I don't want him to start speaking to me. So I just went like that for a bit, right? I don't know how long passed, right? by about maybe 5 minutes or 2 minutes or half a fucking hour, I don't know. But you know how there's like two seats in front, there's two seats, me and Lynn, and in front is another two seats and there's a wee gap between the seats. I fucking opened my eyes and I saw that. You know, like he was looking between the two seats like that. Face all fucking red and all that, and I'm like, I went, and then no long after that, like maybe seconds after that, I heard, excuse me, is his name Brian Lemond? And I went, I was like, fuck my shit like that. I went, right, fuck, I'm gonna have to face the music. And I went like that, and he was stoning up like in front of the, you know, on the seats like that. He went, alright, are you Brian Lemond? Remember, this is before the telly stuff, it wasn't like that. Lemmy, he just knew me for the whole park. He went, are you Brian Lemond? And I went, aye, aye. It was the shittest. I'm just going back to sleep thing. Fakest, shittest, fakest I'm going back to sleep you've ever seen. I must have looked like I was just squeezing my eyes shut to make him go away. You know, I wanted it to kind of look like that. Look. Excuse me. Bring that. Aye, alright. How's it going? Oh, fuck. You know, I wanted it to look all kind of natural, like, oh, you woke me up, oh, how's it going, you alright? Anyway, back get slacks. Maybe speak to you later, I'm knackered, mate, see you later, mate. But instead, it was something like this. Excuse me, is his name Brian Lemond? Is that, excuse me, you Brian Lemond? Aye, alright. It was fucking horrible. It was horrible, and I think I just stayed like that. Maybe not that exaggerated. But kind of like, oh, take a look at it. And don't. What's the matter? You alright? I'm gonna just that guy. Just what guy? Don't fucking say that guy. Don't say that guy. Don't say that guy. Don't say that guy. Don't say that. Like that for about fucking an hour or two for the rest of the journey. So anytime I go like that, it was like that because he's kind of smiling like, fucking horrible. Do you really think we are going to chit chat about the old times, mate? When I'm got a bit fucking, when I come down with two fucking pills, booze, and whatever the fuck that shite was, that paste. I just want to be curled up in my bed, mate. I just want to be curled up under my fucking quilt and know, no, I don't want this. I don't want this to be happening. Civil, thanks for the sub. How's the truck going? It's going really well, thanks. Excuse me, pal. Sorry. Excuse past you. Sorry. Respec and meet Stardust 3 of 3. Ronton. Plastic Orange, thanks for the subs. Are you a fan of Arab Strap? I've never. They have a bit of you, but I've never. I don't think I've ever heard them. Heard of them a lot. I've not heard of them, but never heard them, I don't think. Owl Breath, Miss Mick the Master Fatter, thanks for the subs. Oops, I daisy. Right, you know what? F7. Fuck it. Let's go to the garage. Made an arse. Joe the Heat, thanks for the sub. Current job. There we go, get that fixed. Not a problem, nothing to worry about. Nothing to worry about. Not the end of the world. Not the end of the world. Oh, I need petrol. Istanbul. Shall we end with a little bit of Twitch sings? I will. Maybe. Probably. Perhaps. This week coming up. Get the thing in my bob so I can actually do duets and record my face, because the way I've got the thing set up, it doesn't recognise it as a webcam, if you know what I mean. Open the gate, please. Oh, lovely, lovely. Mr. Scavvy, thanks for 1,000 bits. Seen you some years back at Armadillo, still one of the best shows I've been to. Loving these Twitch streams, thank you very much, mate. That might take at least 5 minutes. You know what I could do? I could do it right now. Do you want me to try and do it right now? I could do it right now, right? Right, let's just see. So here's what I'm going to do. Let me just describe very briefly the nature of the problem. Steve O'Pirate, thanks for the 6 month resub. When the lights go out. Oh, brilliant. And then the lights go out. Modern Warfare 10 years ago on Xbox, man. Glad you like your streams, good old days, eh? B41N, thanks for the sub. Here's the nature of the problem. Everything used to be fine. I had the Elgato HD60S, maybe, don't know. The external one, it's an external thing, it's sitting right there. All it requires is USB power. No, USB which powers and inputs it from the device to the computer, and an HDMI input. Right? That's it. When you do Twitch Sings recognises it as a webcam, you can use it to record the videos today, the duets and all the rest of it. I didn't like that sitting about and all that and the cables and all that, so I thought I'm going to actually get the internal one and like maybe use the external one for something else at some point. So I've got the internal one, so it just takes an HDMI input. No need for the USB because it's plugged directly into the motherboard. Problem is it doesn't see it as a webcam. I can use it for this, but Twitch Sings doesn't recognise it. So in order for me to do the duets, I need to go back to the old way. That requires me to get the thing out. So what I'll be taking is the HDMI output from the cable, that cable that's currently plugged in at the back of the computer. I'll be unplugging that HDMI thing from the back that's plugged into the card, unplugging it. That means this video will go off. I mean, me, the stream will continue, but you won't see me for a bit. And then I plug it into this, and it should just, well, it'll work. I'll then need to add this as a new camera, and hopefully it's all fine. Right. So what I need is, what's that? Oh, good. Right. So. Right. There we go. Cable. Right. I'm going to plug it in the USB at the front. I have had a bad problem with the USB ports at the front of the computer since getting this computer from Scan. But we'll try it anyway. Right. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to unplug the HDMI cable from the back of the computer and I'm going to plug it in here instead. Then I need to add this as a camera source for here. Just make sure that's alright, just so I can see it. Then we switch this back off and do it. The problem is this. For me to get to the back of my computer, I need a mirror. I need to be able to see the fucking angle, or pull the whole fucking computer at an angle. I can't pull the whole thing because the cables are all kind of tightly in, stretched to the maximum fucking limit, precisely in the right fucking place. I can't easily just put the HDMI cable back in. So, if I unplug this USB, the HDMI cable through the back of the computer, and this doesn't work, the stream is over. Because for me to get that back fucking in will take me about 5 or 10 minutes. If I don't want to risk everything fucking collapsing. That is why I have been avoiding this shit for a long time. Because what I've got now works. I'm about to make a big risk. Big chance. Because honestly, it would be a nightmare to try and get that cable back in without moving all sorts of shite that I've got lying on the ground. This needs to move, monitor needs to move, everything needs to move, cups that I've got lying about need to move. Pulling the cable out, no bother. Putting it back in, nightmare. So here we go. Get ready, everybody. And remember, right, here we go. Right, so you're going to hear me, but you're not going to see me for quite a while. You're not going to see me for quite a while. So just hold on. Hold on. G Campbell, thanks for 200 bits. Have you seen the film Sleepaway Camp? If so, no, haven't I? If that's where you came up with Jacqueline, I've not seen it. I'm sorry. Jinzar, thanks for 2113 sub. You ASMR, a legend. Thank you very much, mate. Thank you very much. Right, here we go. Here we go. Right, that cable comes out there and goes back there. That's out there. Right? Then it goes there and it goes there. And it comes down here, right, and then all the way down here, and then it disappears, right, and then it comes all the way back up there, and that's probably it there, right, alright, I can tell you right now, I don't know where the fuck that cable goes into, I can't see it. I'm going to have to use the phone as a mirror. I have no space to get this behind the computer. It requires me to move the computer, which will then stretch the cables to their extremities. Right, here we go. Give us a wee second. No. I can't date that way. I can't get it in enough. It's too dark. I can't see it. I'm going to have to just trace the cable all the way around, even though it's all grouped up. Once it goes into the group of cables, I don't know where it comes out. See, because I've got everything all grouped up all nice and neatly, I kind of follow the path of the cable, because the cable goes in, big bunch of seven cables together. Where does it come out? Which one is it? Don't know. Wait, hold on. Let's try it again. That one goes there, then it goes there, and then it comes down here. Then it goes down there. It goes that way. Then it comes up there. And then it goes there. Then it goes there. And I think that's it there. Here we go. Right. You should no longer be able to see me. Right, alright. Now. Now, what should happen is I've plugged it into that thing, so it should work. Right, hold on. Right, so I need to go to, I'll go to the small one, and then I'm going to add video capture device, go there, create new, and this will be it. There we go, that's Lynn woke up, that's the Elgato dropped on the fucking ground, nearly knocked the water over the computer. That cable dropping down is going to pull the cables at the back of the computer. Right, here we go. Take that off, put that there. Right. Now try that. Are they working? Deactivate. Reactivate. Okay. Go to the full one. Go here. Add a new camera. Video capture device. External camera. Add existing, put that source visible, take that off. Go there. Take off the old one. Just display that one. Go here, double click. OBS virtual camera, Elgato Capture HD. S. Now there I need to install the new drivers. There I need to install the external drivers now. Is that what I've got to do? Have I got to install the external drivers? Possibly. So I might need to download the drivers, everybody, for both the external and the internal one. Configure video. That download will possibly freeze up the stream. Might not work. Might also clash with the drivers for the internal one, possibly, but maybe not. So on and so forth. Right, put that on. Does it work? Maybe switch the camera off and on again. I might do something. Put it back on. Go. Put it back on. Go. Work. I dare you to work. No. Deactivate configure video. No. What can I do? What can I do? Hold on, right. Elgato H, Elgato HD 60S. Let me just check to see, does it actually work with the Elgato software I've currently got? I can't get up. You can't get up because that's it, that's the end of the stream, so I may as well just keep at it. I can't get the cable back in currently. I would have to get a mirror and all the rest of it. Move the cables and things like that. Move the computer. Elgato. So there's nothing on the computer with Elgato, you fucking joking. What's it called then? What's it called then? HD. Game Capture HD, right. Let's see, does this work? If it works with this but doesn't work with OBS, then. Right, that's not what I'm after. This is what I'm after. Detecting signal. Game Capture needs to be connected to a USB 3 port, right, so it's currently. I know that that is a USB 3 port, but the problems that I've had with this scan computer means that the front ports, even though I'm pretty sure the USB 3 do not work as USB 3 because of the problems. So what I'm going to try and do is plug it into the back, even though I know I've had problems with the USB ports at the back because it's a scan computer. Let's continue. Here we go. Is that a port? Is that an actual port? Dropped it. Dropped the fucking cable. Where the fuck did it go? Right. In case you're wondering, I'm trying to get a USB cable. I'm trying to get a USB connector in a port at the back. I kind of see it. They're all taken except one. I don't know which one. Try and see if I can plug it into the one of the ports on in the monitor. Let's try that instead. Get it in the back of the monitor because I kind of see it. I'm going to then use my phone as a mirror and hopefully I can get it in the wee gap at the back. Let's try this now. That water or that will fuck everything up. The cable just dipped in the water there. Luckily it's not the edge of the cable. Right, that's that fucking picture there. Right, let's see. This could be it. Here we go. This could be it. Here we go. This could be it. This could be it. Here we go. Up we go. No. This could be it. This could be it. I kind of see the... I'm just feeling about everybody. I don't know where the fucking ports are. Are they... what... what time is it? Right. Right, there you go. I can see now. Right. That's right. There it is, yeah. Right. Are you sure about that? Right, put that in there. Go. On you go. No, turn that around. Right, here we go. This is it. No. Nope. Need to position the camera just at the right place. Are you sure about that there? Right, that's the one with the guy.